First question is very important one. In triangle ABC, the bisectors of angle B and angle C intersect each other at point O. Bisector of angle B is your OB and angle C is your OC. Intersect at point O here. Then you have to prove that BOC is equal to 90 degree plus half of angle A. Okay, then what to do? I am taking angle sum property of triangle. I know that, or we know that, angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. This is due to angle sum property of triangle. Okay, angle A plus angle B plus angle C equal to 180 degree. Now divide it by 2 both sides. Now A by 2 is A by 2. B by 2 is what? This is angle 1. C by 2 is your angle 2. I am writing B by 2. This is your angle 1. C by 2. This is angle 2. And 180 by 2 is 90 degree. Then what I am going to do? I am sending A by 2 that side. So angle A plus angle 2 will be 90 degree minus A by 2. This is your first thing. Now come on, in triangle BOC, in B is given to you angle 1, this is your angle 2, we have to find angle BOC. So in triangle BOC, angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle BOC is equal to 180 degree by angle sum property of for triangle. What is angle 1 plus angle 2? This is your 90 degree minus A by 2. This is BOC is equal to 180 degree. Then what will be BOC? 180 degree. I am sending 90 degree that side, minus 90 degree and plus A by 2. At last, what is BOC? 180 minus 90 is 90 plus angle A by 2. This is your answer. Question number 2. In a triangle ABC, the sides AB and AC are produced to point P. When triangle is ABC, then sides are produced, AB is produced up to P and AC is produced up to Q. Okay, respectively, the bisectors of PBC, it is your OB, and bisectors of QCB, what is its bisector? Angle bisector OC, and they intersect at a point O. This is point O. Then what you have to prove? You have to prove that BOC is equal to 90 degree minus half of A. Okay, this you have to prove. Now come on, see in the figure ABC, clearly this is your triangle and OB is angle bisector. So this angle and this angle should be equal. That is why I have made 1-1. Here this is again angle bisector. This angle and this angle both are equal. Since this is 2-2. Okay, then it will be very easy. Okay, now I am going to make it because one line it is this. See, this is one type of, linear pair. Okay, one triangle is ABC. It is, I am taking one angle, no? Angle ABC and angle CB and P. This one ABC and CB and P. Okay, ABC is your this and CBP is your twice of angle 1. Clear? This angle ABC and this is your angle CBP. This is of twice of angle 1. So ABC plus angle CBP is equal to 180 degree due to linear pair. Can I write ABC like angle B and CBP 1 and 1 2, angle 1 is coming 2 times. So can I write angle 1 plus angle 1 means twice of angle 1. This is your twice of angle 1 is equal to 180 degree. Now I am transferring this angle B that side. This is minus angle B. And divide it by 2. 180 डिग्री माइनस एंगल बी डिवाइड बाय 2 ओके देन 180 डिवाइड बाय 2 इज 90 डिग्री एंड एंगल बी इज डिवाइड बाय 2 इज एंगल बी डिवाइड बाय 2 ओके इट मींस एंगल 1 विल बी 90 डिग्री माइनस बी बाय 2 सो सिमिलरली यू कैन गेट एंगल 2 दिस विल बी 90 डिग्री माइनस हियर इज एंगल सी सी बाय 2 दिस वेरी क्लियर नो नीड टू राइट अगेन होल थिंग्स ओके कम ऑन इन ट्राइंगल व्हाट इज बीओसी बीओसी हियर इज एंगल 1 प्लस एंगल 2 एंड एंगल बीओसी एंगल 1 प्लस एंगल 2 प्लस एंगल बीओसी इज 180 डिग्री व्हाट इज द रीजन रीजन यू नो बाय एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ ट्राइंगल ओके व्हाट इज एंगल 1 प्लस एंगल 2 दिस एंड दिस एंगल 1 इज योर 90 डिग्री माइनस एंगल बी बाय 2 प्लस व्हाट इज एंगल 2 90 डिग्री माइनस एंगल सी बाय 2 प्लस एंगल बीओसी इज 180 डिग्री दिस इज इक्वेशन 1 यू मार्क इट इक्वेशन नंबर 2 एंड हियर यू कैन राइट बाय 1 एंड 2 इज वेरी क्लियर सेंड ऑल थिंग्स देयर सो बीओसी विल बी व्हाट 180 डिग्री ऑलरेडी My 90 plus 90 is 180. I am sending that side. This will be minus 180 degree. Minus b by 2 then. This will be plus b by 2. Here minus c by 2. This will be plus c by 2. This to this cut. Okay. Now one more important thing I am going to do here. I am adding angle a by 2 and subtracting angle a by 2. Okay. I am adding here. A by 2 and subtracting A by 2. This is my trick. How to solve this? This is my trick here. Okay. So, VOC will be what? Angle A by 2 plus angle B by 2 plus angle C by 2. I have taken these three. And this is minus A by 2 because I want here A by 2. What we know that if I take 1 by 2 common like LCM, so A plus B plus C, angle A plus B plus C, this is this. And what is angle A plus angle B plus angle C? See the triangle. This is your 180 degree. Okay. So I am writing half. This is 180 degree minus angle A upon 2. Okay, so this will be 90 degree minus angle A upon 2. And QT is perpendicular to PR. QT is perpendicular to PR. It means T will be 90 degree. And TQR is 40 degree. It is given to you 40 degree. And SPR is 30. SPR, this is given to you 30 degree. And what you have to find? Find X and Y. It is very easy. Now see, you see and concentrate on two triangles. One triangle is your QTR. QTR. One angle 40 is given to you 40 degree. This is 90. Easily you can get X. 90 plus 40 is what? 130. And 180 minus 130 is what? 50 degree. And that is your X. Now we are writing properly. Come here. Angle Q is your 40 degree. Angle T is your 90 degree. And angle R is what? X. This is 180 degree. Okay. Now come on. This is your what? 130 degree. This is angle X is 180 degree. And what is X? 180 degree minus 130 degree. This will be what? 50 degree. This is your first answer. And what you have to find now? Y. See in triangle. This is your 50 degree, no? X is 50 degree. Now see this triangle. Y is your exterior angle of which triangle? PSR. In triangle PSR. PSR. Angle Y will be equal to 30 degree plus x due to exterior angle property. Angle x I am writing. Exterior angle property. What is exterior angle property? Exterior angle is equal to sum of two interior opposite angles. Okay, so what is angle y? 30 degree. And what is angle x here? 50 degree. Angle y will be 30 degree plus 50 degree. This is your 80 degree. One another answer is. Question number 4. AB is parallel to CD and CD is parallel to EF. AB is parallel to CD and CD is parallel to EF. Two things are given to you. Also, EF is perpendicular to AB. EF is perpendicular to AB. Okay, so this angle A, this should be 90 degree. Okay, and BEF is given to you 55 degree. That is BEF. It is given to you 55 degree and you have to find value of X, Y and Z. Okay, first of all, I am taking this. CD is parallel to EF and this is one transversal line. Okay, these two lines are parallel and this is one transversal line. And what we know, interior angles on the same side of transversal line, its sum is 180 degree. It means Y plus 55 is equal to 180 degree. We can say co-interior angle property also. Okay, so angle Y will be 180 degree minus 55 degree. Tell me what is 10 minus 5 is 5, 7 minus 5 is 2, this is 125 degree. Okay, this is your 125 degree. Now tell me what is the relation between X and Y. These two lines are parallel. AB is parallel to CD. Then these two angles will be which type of angles? Tell me. Yes, co-interior angle. No, this is not co-interior. This is what? This is your corresponding angle. Very good. Okay, this is X and Y. This is 125 degree. This is corresponding angles. Not co-interior. Because angles on the same direction. Like C, you see here. These are corresponding angles. Angles on these two lines are parallel and these two are on the same direction, then this will be your corresponding angle. Don't get confused, no? Then X and Y is we have done. Now see what these two lines are parallel, AB and here EF, these two lines are parallel. So AB is parallel to EF. Okay, then I can say angle BAE plus angle FEA. Angle FEA, this should be 180 degree. And reason is what? Interior angles on the same side of the transversal okay, then it's this sum and this sum, this should be 180 degree. This is your angle A, this is 90. And what is FEA? This is Z plus 55. Angle Z plus 55 is 180. So angle Z is equal to what? This is 145, no? 180. Now, what is angle Z? 180 degree minus 145 degree. This will be what? 10 minus 5 is 5. 7 minus 4 is what? 3. 35. So angle Z is 35.